Hey everybody, Scott Barboza for ESPNBoston.com. High school's coming at you from Natick. It's the group of death we've talked about all season long coming into this MIAA tournament, Division II South, perhaps the most loaded field throughout the state, and another good one going down here with King Philip visiting the Red Hawks. Red Hawks come out with a 39-26 win. Let's go to the highlights. We pick up action. The final Natick drive of the first half. Natick takes over at their own 42-yard line and goes down 58 yards on the final play of the first half. Troy Flutie finding Alex Hilger, his first reception of the first half, a 14-yard touchdown. Both teams having trouble with PATs in the first half. They go to the intermission tied 12-12. KP with the first possession coming out of the half. Now Joe Johnston almost at the century mark at rushing at this point, but then Natick recovers a fumble. Trenton Wright coming up with it here. Huge momentum swing there because just three plays later, it's Flutie to Hilger once again, this time from 18 yards out after a 42-yard connection just a few plays back. With 6:57 left in the third, it's 19-12 Red Hawks. Now later in the third, after an 11-yard touchdown by Joe Johnston to make it 19-all, it's Flutie and Hilger getting back into the act once again. This time, no safety help over the top. Hilger just running down the sideline, 69 yards. PAT, again, no good. It's 25-19. Ensuing KP possession goes three and out. So Natick with the ball again to start the fourth quarter. And this time it's Flutie doing a little work with his feet here, 3 yards after a pass interference. Penalty sets the Red Hawks up with a goal-to-go situation. It's now 32-19. Red Hawks, they add another one late for the 39-26 final. Now, obviously, a couple takeaways here, folks, with Natick advancing now to place Barnstable. Again, that group of death. Any team that comes out of this sectional is going to be a battle-tested team, no doubt. But a couple takeaways from here tonight. First half, KP defense, got to tip your cap to them. Once again, Brian Lee, one of the better game schemers in the state defensively, came with everything but the kitchen sink here. They mixed in a little bit of man. They mixed in some combo coverages. They brought blitz packages from all over the place, inside twist, you name it. The KP defense did it, and they did it effectively. Even Troy Flutie himself talking after the game, telling me he was a little bit, didn't know what was coming and where it was coming from. So again, credit to that Warriors defense. Now, obviously, here in Natick, the offense gets a lot of the accolades, but let's not forget about this defensive group either. They came to play tonight. In particular, middle linebacker Gus Black, I thought, had a very strong game in double digits in tackles. And, of course, KP coming with that two-headed rushing attack with Johnston, who was pretty much at 100 yards through the first half, and Brett McAvoy in the fullback spot, filling in the necessity a little bit more here. Also give a little credit to Natick's defensive line. I thought Trenton Wright was very strong, setting the edge on the outside. Kind of an underrated element there, but they were able to slow KP down in that running attack just enough in the second half to get the offense back on track. Now, of course, it doesn't get any easier from here with Barnstable looming for this Natick team. It's going to be a race to watch no matter what, and we'll keep you up to date throughout it all on ESPNBoston.com High Schools.